Did you know that virtually all of our food is deficient in nutrients? Regardless of where we live or our budget, our food only has a fraction of the nutrition it should have, causing widespread health issues. Many that we don't normally associate with malnutrition, like fatigue, irritability, difficulty concentrating, and depression and anxiety. So it's great to know that research now shows that there is a reliable way to grow nutritious food. Hi, I'm Dr. Wendy Seabrook from Learning from Nature. While everyone raves about organic food, organic growing practices don't guarantee that the food we harvest will have higher nutrient density. Tests comparing certified organic and conventionally grown food aren't always conclusive, except that organic foods tend to contain higher levels of beneficial phytochemicals. Also, we're unlikely to make up for these nutritional deficiencies by eating superfoods like kale, mushrooms, and avocados. Why? Because they have also lost a lot of their nutrients. So it's fantastic that there is now an alternative, reliable, and affordable way to grow nutrient-dense food. A method that anyone can use, whether we are beginners or experienced growers. A method that doesn't require buying newfangled equipment or costly fertilizers. All that's required is giving our soil organisms a better diet. I'll explain how in a moment, but first let me explain why we now know that this is the solution to growing nutrient-dense food. As I've mentioned, while many assessments have compared the differences in the nutritional quality of food between organic and conventionally grown foods, until recently, few have directly considered the influence of the soil in which the food is grown. This recent research has shown that microbial activity and organic matter levels to be the key indicators of the nutritional quality of our food. See below for links to the research mentioned in this video. Organic matter is basically any living or dead animal, plant and plant material. It includes plant and animal remains at various stages of decomposition, living plant roots, microbes, other soil organisms, as well as their excretions. As I said, the research findings show that organic matter levels and microbial activity in soil are indicators of the potential nutrient value of food. But that doesn't mean that we will necessarily grow more nutritious food by simply applying inputs like biofertilizers, compost and mulch. They are not the only things needed to improve our soils and make our food more nutritious. Solely relying on inputs to give our plants all the necessary nutrients just isn't ecological. Imagine all the things that need to be done to enable plants to access the nutrients they require. Making the nutrients in dead leaves, roots, other plant and animal waste materials available to plants is a complex process. It necessitates these organic materials being broken down into smaller and smaller parts by many different soil organisms. Microbes play a vital role, but earthworms, woodlice, snails, other invertebrates, and other soil organisms are also required. Together, they recycle nutrients, communicate with plants, and make the required nutrients available to plants for reuse. Their combined expertise is also necessary to control pests and pathogens in soil and to maintain a habitable soil environment. Therefore, we need to build healthy soil communities that maintain functioning ecosystems to grow nutrient-dense food. Soil organisms have perfected all the required skills over the millions of years of on-the-job training. What's holding them back are insufficient resources to apply these skills to their best potential. Unfortunately, we've caused this problem by managing our vegetable gardens, orchards and fields to maximise plant growth to feed us and our livestock, neglecting the supply of plant materials to our soil organisms. The solution, therefore, is to find ways to give our soil organisms a better diet while still maintaining food production for us and our livestock. Our soil communities need a more generous and diverse supply of leaves, manure, other organic waste materials, and food from root tissues and root exudates. And root exudates are the sugars and proteins plant release from their roots. Soil organisms need these resources also for as much of the year as possible. A varied diet will create a more biodiverse soil community, and research shows that as a result, our soil organisms get our ecosystems working better, faster. Many farmers participating in the research grew diverse cover crops with crop rotations, providing evidence that farming practices increasing the amount, diversity and consistency of food supplies to soil organisms improves the nutritional content of food. However, there are many other ways to give our soil organisms a better diet. By learning to respond to our local conditions, observing and working with the experts at managing our soil ecosystem, we can develop practical tools to grow nutritious food in our vegetable gardens, orchards and fields. We talk more about these practical tools in the next video. If you want more guidance on how to use this ecological approach in your garden or farm, these handbooks might help. See the links in the description below.